The Theater at Solaire serves as a revolving door for some of the biggest theatrical experiences in the world. The running play is Andrew Lloyd Webber's The Phantom of the Opera, longest-running play on Broadway with over 12,000 performances over the last 31 years. With a 73-person crew and 384 costumes, it's a massive production that's here in Manila for a brief engagement.
How's Manila been treating the troupe?
Amazing. We've had a wonderful time in Manila so far. It's really nice. We managed to rehearse here and open the show here. So we've been here for quite a while, which meant we've actually been able to get out and see the city a little more than normal
and
meet the people. Mm-hmm. And everyone here is so lovely. Everyone is so welcoming. Yes. And even to the show, you know, big applause, standing ovations, all that kind of stuff. It's wonderful.
Yeah.
There's 73 people on tour.
73?
Yeah, 73 that tour from place to place, city to city. And of that, 37 of them are cast, and the rest are technicians or backstage staff, so stage management or lighting, sound, wigs, wardrobe, you know. We have 384 costumes in the show.
Yeah.
So we tour 384, and 186 of those are on stage every night. Yeah, and 224 pairs of shoes that we stick out there as well, that are out every night.
What makes the audience like the play?
I think it's something to do with families, and I think people watched this show when they were a child, and now they're an adult, they're watching the show again, and they're bringing their children because they loved it so much. And I feel like it's one of those shows that's been going for so long and that engages the audience so much that people just keep coming back. And the love story, of course.
And the music.
The music, absolutely. Yeah. It all ties in perfectly, the beautiful sets and the drama. They just love it.
And now it's time for us to partake of the music of the night. See you after curtain call. After the show, I've invited LA, Georgia, and Christian to join me at Solaire's cigar bar and poker room to catch up and try the finest cigars they have. Meanwhile, I've got to try a cigar or two from the bar just to get a little taste.
First time ako mag-sigarilyo, mag-cigar, what would you suggest I get?
Davidoff.
The Davidoff.
Primeros, Nicaragua, from Dominican Republic.
From this,
The Davidoff cigar is full-bodied and smooth and feels just a little bit heavy.
Now, Natasha tells me this is the lightest one, but to me it's quite potent and strong, but since I haven't smoked a cigar in over 30 years, so this is like my first time all over again.
The Cigar Bar is the hotel's chicest new spot that offers classic cocktails and a wide selection of local and Central American cigars. After a quick stop at the cigar booth, it's time to meet my friends and senior beverage manager Michael O'Shea for cocktails.
Michael, tell me about the cigar room. What's it all about?
Well, it's our newest, most kind of chic bar on property.
Yeah.
We opened about 3 months ago.
3 months.
The cocktails are straightforward, but Michael gives them a unique cigar bar twist.
How often do you change your cocktails?
So probably in the next 3 months, we'll be adding some new stuff. So I want to keep the change going.
Yeah.
You know, obviously we'll already have these on the deck, so the staff can always suggest these as well. And then new stuff always coming and re-changing.
So what did you want to create the ambiance of the cigar bar?
It's almost like every man's little like boudoir, right? It's like your own little man's cave in each area of the place you go.
Yeah.
So every space has its own unique little cave, and it's quiet enough to enjoy, but it's also, you can be as loud as you want, whoever you're with and the group you're with.
The interiors and ambiance makes us feel right at home in this beautiful man cave with soft jazz music in the background and old Hollywood movies playing on screen.
I love the old movies.
It's
a nice touch.
Yeah, we're still adding more to the role play of it too, so we keep that feel of old and classic.
Yes. And how's your drink?
Oh man, that's amazing. It's refreshing, but it's not sweet. I don't really like sweet drinks, so this is perfect.
Yeah. You get a little smokiness to it when you smell it?
Yeah. A little bit, not too much. It's not overbearing, so you get like just a touch of smoke.
Yeah, good. Yeah, it's supposed to be, it'll be sprayed on the outside so you get it on your fingers, and when you smell it, when you drink it, it's always kind of in your face.
Thanks for having us here.
No, I appreciate it. It's nice to have all of you.
Yes, I love this place. It's a nice getaway from upstairs.
Cheers.
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 After a lovely play and a night's rest at the presidential suite, Solaire is sending me off in a Rolls Royce, a luxurious ride to cap off a brief, relaxing trip just within the metro. Taking an air taxi ride to catch breakfast on the other side of Metro Manila was a brand new experience. The presidential suite was one of my most magnificent I've ever seen, while the firing range had me with heart in my throat. I got to catch up with my dear friends over dinner, cocktails, and a Tony Award-winning musical, and we never even had to leave the building. That's some world-class hospitality. Till our next adventure, I am Raul Manzano, and this is EIC On The Move.